Hey everyone, welcome back. Today we'll be talking about absolute value. What is the absolute value, you may ask? Well, the absolute value is the distance from zero on a number line. So how far a number is, whether negative or positive, from zero on the number line. The absolute value of a number is always positive. Now, if you look here, these bars represent the symbol for absolute value. And here where the A is located, this is having some number, whether negative or positive, inside those bars. Now, take a look at these two individuals. One of them, the gentleman, is walking backwards. The other, the lady, is walking forward, but they have the same objective. They want to get to this mailbox. Now, they're walking at the same pace, and they're going the same distance. Do you think one of them will have a negative distance? Well, if absolute value is related to distance and absolute value is always positive, then we know that whether they're walking backwards or forwards, right, they're going the opposite position, we know that the distance is going to be the same. Now, let's put this in the context of math. So here we have the number line where it's zero in the center. We have our positive numbers to the right. So over here are our positive numbers. And to the left of zero, we have negative numbers. Okay. Now remember the position of zero, which is here. Now, if I want to go to the number 5, so I want to travel from 0 to 5, let's take a look at my distance. So I'm going to use the frog method, which is just jumping from one spot to the other so that I can count my number of spaces properly. So I'm jumping. So to go from 0 to 5, I hopped 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces. Now let's say I want to go to negative 5. Okay, again, I'm starting at 0, that's my starting point, and I'm going to hop. So let's count the spaces. 1 space, 2 spaces, 3 spaces, 4 spaces, 5 spaces. So the distance from 0 to positive 5 is the same distance as 0 to negative 5. And that's where the absolute value idea comes in. So the absolute value of negative 5 is equal to 5, right? 5 spaces. The distance is 5. The absolute value of, let me change this color. The absolute value of a positive 5 is also 5. Okay. Let's take a look at another example. What is the absolute value of negative 3? So again, absolute value is my distance from 0. So I want to go here at negative 3. I'm going to start at 0 and I'm going to hop. So the absolute value from 0 to negative 3 is 3. Okay, let's try one more. What about the absolute value of positive 6? Same concept, starting at 0. And count my number of spaces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the absolute value of 6 is equal to 6. Okay. Now let's try a few examples that require a little bit more work. So if you look at this example here, you see 23 inside the absolute value bar, but then if you notice, there's a negative on the outside. So now when I take a look at this, the absolute value of 23 is going to be 23. But there's a negative sign outside the bar. So this negative sign will not change. I will just merely bring it over to my answer. Okay, now let's take a look at this example. The absolute value of a positive 6 is 6. The absolute value of a negative 9 is 9. This plus sign is not inside the absolute value bar, so I bring it down. And then I can just perform the operation of addition. So 6 plus 9 is equal to 15. Now let's try this one. So here we see the absolute value bar is used as a grouping symbol. So here I'm going to perform my order of operations. So PEMDAS tells me that addition and subtraction are on the same level from left to right. So I'm going to subtract and then add. 6 minus 5 is 1 plus 4. So this is the absolute value of 5, which is just equal to 5. Now let's look at the next example. What is the absolute value of 8? That's going to be 8. What is the absolute value of negative 9? That's 9. Now there's a subtraction sign that's not in an absolute value bar because this bar belongs with this one and this one belongs with this one. So I bring that minus sign down. Now I have to apply my rules of adding and subtracting integers. So different signs, subtract, and keep the sign of the larger number. So my answer here is negative 1. Now we have some fractions. The concept is still the same. So negative 2/3, the absolute value of negative 2/3 is going to be 2/3. And that negative sign on the outside, we'll just bring it over. Okay, so let's take a look at some different examples. Okay, so here I have my number line and I'm going to actually plot some points and we're going to identify the location of those points from zero or from each other. So let me plot my first point and I'm going to call that point A. Okay, now I want to know what is the distance of A from zero. Now before I start hopping and determining what my distance is, I want you to pay close attention to your interval. So here we're going from zero, but then there's a dash in between it, and then I get to one. So this dash looks like it's exactly halfway in between. So I know that this is a half. And then one, this would be 1.5, so on and so forth. Now let's go ahead and find the location of A from zero. So I'm jumping one space, two spaces, and then I go halfway. So the distance from 0 to A is 2.5. Okay, now let's plot another point. Let's plot a point here and let's call that point B. Now I want to know the distance, not from 0 this time, but from A to B or B to A. Okay, let's go from B to A. So I'm going to start here and I'm going to hop. Okay, so now let's count our spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.5. So the distance from B to A is 6.5. Now let's take another look. Let's say I plot a point at negative 3. And we're going to call that point K. And I want to find a point that is located at 7.5 spaces away from K. Now, based on my number line and the fact that it stops at negative 5, I might not be able to jump in that direction, right? So if I'm just limited to this number line, I'm going to go to the right. So I'm trying to go 7.5 spaces. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.5. So 7.5 spaces from K takes me to 4.5. And if I say plot a point and name it Z, then that's where the point would be located at 4.5. Now here's a word problem. It says, the graph shows the position of a diver relative to sea level. So sea level, some important terms in here is that sea level represents zero. Below sea level represents my negative. So here, these are below sea level. And anything above sea level would be considered exactly that, above sea level, which is positive. So use absolute value to find the diver's distance from the surface. So the surface of the water is here. Right? This is the surface. And the diver is located here. So here we see our interval based on the markers. It's counting by ones. So 0 to negative 6, right? That's the distance of 6. From here to here is another 6. From here to here is another 6. So the absolute value of 18, of negative 18, sorry, which is where he's located, is 18. And in this case, we do have units. The units here are feet. So we would say that the diver is 18 feet below sea level. So that is his position. Thank you for watching and have a great day.